meter square, we have to find the breadth of the rectangle. Now the perimeter of rectangle is already given, 82 meters. So perimeter is the sum of the boundaries, that is the sides. So this is 41 minus x. This will also be x. So the perimeter is x plus 41 minus x plus 41 minus x plus x. That is, this gets cancelled, this gets cancelled. So it is 82, which is given in the question also. And the area is 400 meter square. That is, area is length into breadth. So you can take this as length or this as length. So length into breadth, that is x into 41 minus x, this is given to be 400 meter square. So we have to find the breadth. First we have to solve x, then we can get length and breadth also. So this will be 41x minus x square equal to 400. Let us take these two on the right hand side. So you get x square minus 41x and then 4 plus 400 equal to 0. So 400 can be written as, because this is 400. 400 is nothing but 25 into 16, because you are trying to get 41x. This can be written as x square minus 25x minus 16x plus 400 equal to 0. You can take x common, it would be x minus 25. You can take minus 16 common, x minus 25. This is equal to 0. So x minus 16 and x minus 25 is equal to 0. So these are the roots. So you get x equal to 16, you get x equal to 25. So either you take 16, if you take 16, this will be 41 minus x will be, 41 minus x will be 20. See, this is simply 45 minus x, 25, because 25 and 16 we have taken. So 45 minus x will be 25. If you take x equal to 25, 41 minus x will be 16. So the length and breadth are 16 and 50. Okay. So it can be either of the breadth can be either 16 or it can be 25. The length of the hall is 5 meter more than the breadth. So if the length is x, the breadth is x plus 5. If the area of the floor of the hall is 84 meter square, what is the area? Length into breadth. So x into x plus 5 is given as, for 84, we have to find the length and breadth. So here specifically it is given that length of the hall is 5 more than the breadth. So this is your breadth and this is your length, right? So specifically we know breadth and length. So let us solve it. This will be x square, this will be 5x, bring 84 here. Now how to write 84 so that we can get 5? 84 is, you can write it as 12 into 7. This will be x square plus 12x minus 7x minus 84 equal to 0. You take x common, x plus 12, you take minus 7 common, x plus 12. So what do you get? x minus 7 and x plus 12. That means from here you get x equal to 7, from here you get x equal to minus 12. Minus 12 you simply discard because it cannot be negative, the length cannot be negative. X is 7, so this is 7. This x plus 5 is nothing but 7 plus 5, that is 12. So this 5 and 12. So length is 7 and breadth is 12. Two squares have sides x and x plus 4. The sum of their area is 656. Find the side of the square. So square, what is the area of the square? Area of square is side square. So the area of first square will be x square. The area of second square, that is x plus 4, will be side square, that is x plus 4 whole square. This is the area of first square, this is the area of second square. The sum is given as 656. This question we already done in the previous discussions, but we'll try to do it again. This will be x square. X plus 4 whole square will be x square plus 16 plus 8x. Bring 656 here, 656. This x square will be 2x square. This is 8x, and then 16 minus 656 is your, you get 320, 640 actually. This is 640. Now take 2 outside, or you can divide both sides by 2. So your equation will become x square plus 4x minus 320. Now 320 can be written as 16 into 20. So the 4 can be written as x square plus 20x minus 16x minus 320. Take x common from here, x plus 20. Take minus 16 common from here, x plus 20. So you get x plus 20 and x minus 16 as the factors. From here you get x equal to minus 20, from here you get x equal to 16. We don't take the negative ones because the dimension cannot be negative. X equal to 16, and this, if it is 16, this side of the first square is 16, the other will be x plus 4, that is 20. The area of right angle triangle is 165 cm square. Determine the base and altitude if the latter exceeds the former by 7 meters. So, we have a right angle triangle like this. Okay. The area is given. Area is half into base, that is this one, into altitude. So, determine the base and altitude, that is this is base and this is altitude. If the latter exceeds the former by 7 meters. So, latter means half. See, if you say former and this is latter. So, latter always comes after. Former always comes before. So, we have to determine the base and altitude if the latter exceeds the former by 7 meters. So, what is, this is the former, base is former, so this is the former and this height is latter. So, it is given that if the latter, that is this one, exceeds the former by 7, that is, if this is x plus 7, simply like this. So, now we can just say half into base is x, altitude is x plus 7. Equal to 165. So, we just have to solve this one. Half into x plus 7 equal to 165. Now, you can also take in a different way. If this is x, height you take it as x, or altitude you take it as x, and base you have to take as x minus 7. So, both ways you will get the same answer. That is half into x minus 7, you are going to get 165. So, both ways you are going to get the same answer. Okay. So, the base and altitude, if the latter exceeds the former by 7. So, latter, this one exceeds this by 7. So, here by solving this equation, we will get x, which is assumed to be height. But by this equation, you will get base, which was assumed to be x. So, we will go with this one, half into x minus 7 into x. So, this will be 165 into 2, that is 330. X into x minus 7 is x square minus 7x. So, x square minus 7x, bring it here. X square minus 7x minus 330. Now, 330 can be written as 22 into 15. So, this is 7x can be written as minus 22x plus 15x. Now, you can take x common from here, x minus 22. You can take minus 15 common, you get x minus 22. So, you have two factors, x minus 22 and x plus 15. From x minus 22, you get x equal to 22. From x plus 15, you get x equal to minus 15. So, you see here negative we cannot take because the dimension cannot be negative. The positive is x equal to 22. So, x equal to 22 is the result. But if you take, if you see this, x is 22, the other one will be x minus 7. So, this was assumed x, in this case, this is assumed altitude to be x. So, the base is x minus 7, that is, if this is 22, base will be x minus 7, that is 15. But if you have taken this equation and you have solved it, this would have come 15 and this would have come 22. So, the same things remain the same. Okay. It is possible to design the question is being asked, is it possible to design a rectangular mango grove whose length is twice its breadth and the area is 800 meters square? Find the length and breadth. So, we will just first take these dimensions and then we will see whether it is possible or not. So, we have a rectangular mango grove whose length is twice as its breadth. So, if length is, say breadth is x, the length will be 2x and the area is 800. So, x into 2x is equal to 800. That is, you have 2x square equal to 800. So, x square is equal to 400. X becomes plus minus under root 400. So, x will be equal to plus minus 20, but we will not take the negative sign. It will be x equal to 20. So, x comes to be 20, x come to be 20 and x was what? We assume this to be, because it was say being said, length is twice its breadth. So, this is breadth, this is length. So, the breadth which is x, breadth is 20 and length is 2 into 20, that is 2 into 20 which is 40. So, it is possible to design like this. So, this is x, this is 2x, 800, x into 2x equal to 800 and x was found to be 20. So, the next question is it possible to design a rectangular park of perimeter 80 and area 400 meter square? If so, find its length and breadth. So, the perimeter is 80, that is, we know that the area of a rectangle is what? If you take this as x, length as x and width as y. So, we know that this perimeter for 80 will be nothing but this will also be x, this will also be y. So, 2x plus 2y, 2 into x plus y you can say. So, 2 into x plus y is equal to 80. That is, you get 40 as x plus y. So if one is x, you can change this y because we need the quadratic equation. So for that y, you can write it as y as 40 minus x. So if you assume length to be x, y becomes 40 minus x. Now if you see, the area is 400 meters square, that is length into breadth. Length is say x, breadth is 40 minus x. Length into breadth is 400 meters square. So the question is like this. So what do you get? 40x minus x square equal to 400. Now take these two on this side. So x square minus 40x plus 400 equal to 0. If 400 you can write always as 20 into 20. So x square minus 20x plus 400 equal to 0. You take x common x minus 20. You take minus 20 common x minus 20. So x minus 20, basically it is at x minus 20 whole square. x minus 20 you get. So x minus 20 equal to whole square equal to 0, that is x equal to 20. So once x is 20, what is y? 40 minus x. That is y will be 40 minus x, y will 40 minus 20, you get 20. So the length and breadth are 20 and 20. So it is possible. Now the next question is, sum of the area of square is 640. If the difference of their perimeter is 64 meter square, find the sides of two square. So first, we have to consider the square. The area of square is side square. So if this is x, it will be x square. If you take side as y, it will be y square. And what will be the perimeter? Perimeter is simply the sum of the sides. So it will be 4x. If you take side as y, it will be perimeter is 4y. So now we have two squares. So first square, we take s1 and s2 as the two square. Now, let us assume that the first s1 will have side as x meter and the other will have y meter. Now, the difference of their perimeter is 64. That is, if the, as I said, it will be 4 into x and 4 into y will be the perimeter. So 4x and 4y will be the perimeter and the difference is 16. So 4x minus 4y is equal to 16. That is x minus y equal to 16. So x becomes 16 plus y. So we are going to use this x equal to y plus 16 in the other equation. The other equation is sum of two areas is equal to 640. That is, sum of area x square plus y square is the area. If we assume x and y as two separate squares. So x square plus y square is equal to 6, this 640 is being given. So what do you get? We are putting x as y plus 16 here. So we are putting x as y plus 16. So 640 is equal to y square plus 16 square is 256 and 2 into y into 16 is 32. So this is y we have taken. So it will be y square plus 256 plus 2 into 16 into y, that is 32y. Now you see that this y square will become 2y square. And I am bringing 640 here also. So it will be minus 640. So 2y square plus 32y, 256 minus 640 is 384. Now divide both sides by 2. So this 2 will be eliminated. That is y square plus 16y minus 192 will come. 192 can be written as 24 into 8. So 16 can be written as y square plus 16y minus 192. 16y can be written as 24y minus 8y. So you can take y common from here, y plus 24 will come. You can take minus 8 common from here, y plus 24 will come. So y plus 24 and y minus 8 is going to come. This will give you y equal to minus 24. This we disregard because dimension cannot be negative. This will give you y equal to 8. So y equal to 8. What will x be? X is y plus 16. So x is simply y plus 16. That is 8 plus 16. This is going to give you 24. So one area will have side as 8. The other area will have side as 24.